successful leaders, and it's almost top down. Dr. Bearden wants us to look at the user, learner profile and our community values on the next screen. This is what the students and parents, and we did surveys, these are the things that they value. We want our students want to be prepared to be college and career ready. And Ms. Cheney went over some of these again. We want those life skills. We want them to be able to explore and expand opportunities. And then they want to, we want to pursue excellence. Just like any adult here, I don't know that anybody's happy where they are. We always want more. So that's what we want to produce, successful young adults who want those same things. And here's the Raider U logo. Ms. Cheney went over this as well. It's not necessarily the Raider University. It's Raider U. You will. You know, you will be college career ready. You will have life skills. You will pursue opportunities and pursue excellence. So that's where that, when you see that logo, that's what that logo means. And we kind of put it together. We really like that logo. And so that everybody knows, Raider U, again, covers 9th and 10th grade. We put this together. We just started this year. This was the first year we've done it this year to make sure that we're giving our students the tools to be successful in high school and then at the elite level. The breakdown at Raider U currently, we team up, an administrative teams up with a counselor, and we have an alphabet, as you can see on here, myself and Ms. Adams. We have last names A to GQ, Ms. Waddell, Mr. Owens, who's over here. Mr. Owens, you got him inside. There's Ms. Adams. And then Ms. Maddie is teamed up with Kim Oliver, and they have P through Z. So when you have questions, these are the people you can go to. A lot of the scheduling, class-related type questions, you want to go through your counselor, because they're going to work with you hand-in-hand to make sure that your students sign up for the right classes and have the right graduation requirements. Now, when we talk about Raider U and Raider Nation, right now we're focused on Raider U. But your students at some point are going to be in Raider Nation once they get to 11th grade. But here's kind of some of the transition. We want you to explore and work on plans so that you can implement anything you've learned in the first 2 years. We want to make sure students transition to high school well, giving them the proper tools so they can graduate and finalize their plan after high school. The tools for success are huge. Raider U is really a school thing. If we give your 9th and as when they turn 10th grade, the tools to be successful, junior and senior year, they're going to do very well. SEL, for those who don't know, that's social emotional learning and academic support. We provide that through Raider U so that those students can pursue those opportunities we talk about once they get into 11th and 12th grade. And then exposure to opportunities. There are different things we want to expose them through IF. A lot of the classes go on class trips where they're exposed to different things. So this is really a culmination of Raider U and Raider Nation coming together to go back to that learner profile for us to produce successful high school students and adults.
Okay, so now we're going to get into the agenda for today. You are holding a packet in your hand. I'm about to go over the material in that packet in just a second. Once we go through the packet, we're going to talk about high school basics, the academic choice options that you're going to have for 9th grade year for your students. We're going to talk about registration in detail. We will spend a lot of time on the registration because that's what you're about to do right now. Understand that the high school basics, it is going to be just bare minimum what you need to know. The reason for that is we have opportunities before your students start on our campus where we will go in greater detail about what they need to know to be successful their freshman year. We don't want to overwhelm anyone today. Then we're going to talk about upcoming events, and we'll have a question and answer session. Also, just so I don't forget, this presentation will be posted on our website, so don't feel the need to write everything we say down. You'll be able to review it again at your own leisure. And we do have our Raider Nation counselors in the media center, so if we don't get to a question that you have in here, you have an opportunity to ask them in there, okay? So with your packet, Ms. Maddie's kind of helping me over here too. You've got your cover, and then when you get in there, I know you can't read this, but you can see it in your packet. It's Raider Essentials. So this is the basic breakdown between administrators, counselors, who the team pairings are, how to contact them, and then over on the far side, you'll see, okay, if I need to check my student out, how do I do that? When my student needs a work permit, who do I go to? So this is your one-stop shop. This will absolutely help you have a successful start at North Forsyth High School, but really, this is a reference tool. Keep it. It will help you all 4 years. There's the High School 101 page. This, again, is going to be your bare minimum basics. definitely broken down as far as 7-period classes. What is a GPA? How does that look like between your cumulative and HOPE? So all that information is there for you to refer back to. And again, that's the kind of stuff we'll go into greater detail at Greater Rush, which happens in late July. There's a 4-year academic plan. This is a sample. This just gives you an idea of what courses your students may take along their 4 years of high school and their 4 years at North Forsyth High School. And then a sample schedule. So we're gonna go over, like I said, registration in great detail, but what are we trying to register for? What we're registering for is to create a schedule like this. And this is, again, just a sample of what your student schedule may look like. Then you've got the pathway choices. You'll notice we have a ton of pathways. The purpose of today is to go over the registration details, but to also give you guys and your students an opportunity to explore our campus and explore the CTAE, the fine arts, and of course the academic pathways that we offer here at North. And then the last few pages are about the registration. So if you have directions that are written, and then if you're like me, I'm a visual learner, so I put together the visual directions as well just so that it can help you guys follow through with step-by-step process. Before we get into the meat of this presentation, raise your hand if this is your first high school student. Awesome, a good number. Okay, now raise your hand if you've already had a high school student go through, especially at North. Okay, so the ones that had your hands up first, these are your friends. They will help you. Okay, we are here for you. We know that this may be your first or second. Every student's different, but the good news is this isn't our first high school student. So we are here for you. Please reach out to us. We're here to support you guys, and we really do say we're a family for a reason. The last page that you have in your packet is going to be the registration page. On that page, you will notice it has all the course offerings for 9th grade. We broke it down because the course opportunities are so vast in high school that if you saw every course we offer in the school, it would totally overwhelm you. So this is just for 9th grade. And one thing I do want to point out is that there is a Spanish 1 sticker that's been added that has just recently come down. We're excited to let you know we will be offering Spanish 1 next year. So that's why that was added in that way. But just, you know, that's on that packet for you. And now Mr. Owens is going to go over the high school basics.
Good morning. Just want to give you a quick overview of what's expected for graduation requirements. A lot of students actually are coming in now with credits before they even get here. So many of you will have Spanish credit, maybe accelerated math credit, or physical science credit, or fine arts credit. So a lot of you already have a jump start on getting to the 23 total credits that you'll need to graduate. And 23 is really just a minimum. Most students get above and beyond that and end up with 28, 30 credits, but it's always good to be aware of the minimum and know exactly which areas you need certain credits in. So, 4 language arts credits, your student would have 9th grade lit next year and then move on through 3 other Englishes each of the years here. 4 math credits, 4 science, 3 social studies, and then health and personal fitness is required for all freshmen, or if you're an ROTC, and you do 3 credits in that, that can take the place of a health and personal fitness credit. So just keep that in mind. And also you need a combination of 3 career tech or world language or fine arts credits to graduate. Those can be 3 in the same pathway or a mix of 3 for graduation requirements. We encourage kids to go through 3 in a row, but we know their minds change about things. But 3 in a row makes them a pathway completer. And then 4 additional electives. That could be like PE or weight training or driver's ed or something like that. That'll get you to at least the minimum of 23 credits. So this is just a quick overview of the academic courses that you may see for your student in 9th grade. Of course, you're gonna have your English, math, science, social studies, and personal health, fitness, and health. Most of those will be in there. The social studies is optional, but they'll at least see 4 or 5 of those, and then beyond that would be the electives that you guys get to choose in the portal coming up soon. So, there are a couple options for English, and we're gonna go through each of the different subject areas today. The department chairs are actually available out in the cafeteria today. If you have questions about the differences between the course, we encourage you to talk with them. If you're on the border between 9th Lit and 9th Lit Honors, you're not sure which one you want to do, we encourage you to talk with them and get some more information about the differences between the two. But the eighth grade teachers recommend these courses. So when you go into the portal in a week or two, you'll see these courses in there, and you'll either see ninth lit or ninth the honors for the English. And then for the math, there's several different options. We have our Foundations of Algebra, Algebra 1. Algebra 1 with support. If your student needs a little bit of extra repetition with the math, it mirrors the Algebra 1 support class. And then we have our Accelerated Algebra 1 Geometry A Honors. And then we have our Accelerated Geometry B Algebra 2 Honors. Now that's a mouthful, but the last one I just said is if you had already earned credit in eighth grade for that Excel Algebra 1 and Geometry A Honors. So if you're thinking about wading into different things, I encourage you to talk with the math department chair today, Ms. Swofford. She's going to be out there because there are a lot of different options for the math. In science, there's a few different options as well. We have environmental, biology, and biology honors. Environmental is something we started offering in the last couple years for students who may need another transition into high school to get ready for an EOC course, because the biology, which a lot of students do take in the ninth grade, is an EOC course, and it's pretty challenging. So if you feel like your student, it might need a year to adjust and get ready for that tough biology course to 10th grade year, environmental science might be recommended for them. So you also have the on-level biology and the biology honors. And Dr. Graham's here today also, if you need to speak with her about some differences between the two, the three. All right, so social studies is not required freshman year. However, we encourage students to take them if they feel ready for them. So one of the main classes we encourage students to think about taking is AP Human Geography. Now this one could be recommended or waived into. But it's a social studies elective credit, and it is a college level course in the ninth grade that you can take. You can take the AP exam at the end of the year, could get college level credit. It's developmentally appropriate for ninth graders, even though it's a college level course. We have experienced teachers who work with these students on study skills and getting them ready. And it's really a gateway course to other AP courses later on. So if you're in that, Scott Beard will be here today to talk a little bit more about that. We also have another option, World Geography, which is a semester-long class, and this is one you would need to sign up for on the portal. And with this one, you would need to choose another elective to go with it, a semester elective like lifetime sports or driver's ed. So it gives you a couple different options to get exposed to social studies.
Sure. Good morning again. I want to reiterate something that Mr. Owens said. We highly encourage all ninth graders to try to take a social studies class. What we found, students that have not, ninth graders have not taken social studies, struggle typically when they transition into their 10th grade course. And that students that do take a social studies class perform better in a lot of indicators. And so we highly, highly encourage students to take one or two of these. One of our goals here at the school is to have every student take an AP course, an advanced placement course. And so, if you're sitting on the fence with AP Human and you weren't recommended, but you know you're a hardworking student, we'll work with you. It's gonna be tough, but that's what we wanna do, is challenge you here in many ways. So highly, highly recommend that you take a social studies course if you can. I know some of you have band and some other electives and it gets tight with your schedule, but highly, highly recommend that.
All right, another course that could be recommended or you can sign up for would be a language. Now, most students will go on and take a language their freshman year, but if your student needs a year to transition to high school, they can wait and take one sophomore year too. And we can help talk with you guys and work through that to determine what's the best fit for you guys. But you could see Spanish 2 recommended in there for next year if you're getting Spanish 1 credit in the eighth grade. And then, like Ms. Evans has said, we do have Spanish 1 available, and then we have our first level languages in French, German, Latin, and Russian. So you can talk today with Ms. Curran if you have any questions about specifics on those languages.
Talking to you now as a current ninth grade parent and a counselor for 13 years prior, she would have had world geography, law, Spanish. She was playing basketball. She could run a track. Now, that might have been overwhelming. So I encourage you, as a parent and as a former counselor, have that conversation with me and your family. Think about those things. What is my kid going to be involved in? What's my kid's work at? How much time does my kid spend doing work? Have that conversation within your family. So it will be very beneficial in the long run.
Another thing to consider about world languages, too, is you, for college admissions, you need at least 2 and preferably 3 for competitive admissions to college. So just keep that in mind. You actually don't have to have 2 to graduate. You can get those in other ways. But most of our students go on to 2 and 4 years colleges. So you would need at least 2 for that, preferably 3. We'll have you let you have a little bit more competitive resume for college. Now, we have a lot of different fine arts electives. And we have visual arts, music theory, drama, percussion, music technology, tech theater, acting, band, guitar, musical theater, and chorus. And so a lot of these are audition or application. Our applications are on the website right now if you need to look at those and go ahead and start that process. And then audition would be drama, chorus, and band. What you would do for those is there's a generic number there without a Y or an S on your course list. You just sign up for those, and then you'll get in contact with the department chair or the leader for that area, and then you'll do an audition. So there's lots of different options there. Mr. Cease is available today out there if you can talk with him. CTAE, we have 15 different pathways here. A lot of these are very popular. And there's really too much to go into here, but I would encourage you today to walk around and start looking into them a little bit more. If you need more information, we have a course digest on our website as well. You can read all the ins and outs about that, about the sequence, the course overview, and all of that. So there's tons of information there for that. And then additional ninth grade electives. So driver's ed is also available. It's not, you don't have to take it here at the school, but we do offer it for $100. It's a semester course, so if you choose driver's ed, you could put it with your world geography class if you wanted to do that, or you could do it with a lifetime school. Spirit awareness course, cool story if you can catch that. All right, so the driver's ed, the world geography, and the lifetime sport are all semester electives that you could pair together in some form or fashion. Also, there's a general PE class that's year-long. Weight training, you probably want to talk with your coach and your sport about whether you want to do weight training in ninth grade year. What we don't want is kids just loading up and taking all PE in ninth grade, so we encourage you to mix in a career tech, a language, or a PE if you need to do that. Journalism, we have a yearbook staff, takes applications, that's available on the website. We also have a newspaper staff, and these are great programs you can get into. Both are application-based, so just fill that out and get it turned in. Those are the contacts over there if you have any questions. And then we talked about the audition process and application process for some of those other classes, and there's the contact names for those if you need those. And then this is a sample of ninth grade schedule. When you come back, you won't see this anytime soon, but when you come back for Raider Rush before school starts, you'll get to tour the school, you'll get your actual schedule, be able to walk around and find your way around, but you'll see 7 classes there on Monday, Tuesday, and Friday, and we do a little bit different thing on Wednesday and Thursday where we block it up with an instructional focus class. So that's kind of what you'll see is a general schedule when you come back. So 7 classes that mostly last year long, or there'll be some semester electives for maybe 1 or 2 classes that you have.
Okay, now let's get ready to register. So if you will turn in your packet to the visual directions, also the written directions, and the registration course guide of it. So on February 21st, the portal is going to open. The registration portal opens, and it opens on Parent Portal. That's how you will log in. And before that, there are a few things that you need to know. For those core academic courses, so for the math, science, social studies, language arts, and world language, you are going to be recommended. Your student is going know, with social studies, your student will be recommended for AP Human Geography, but they will not, there's no recommendations for World Geography. So that one you would add on your own as an elective. Also in World Language, your student will be recommended for Spanish 2, but all other language courses first level are going to be treated just like any other elective, so you would have to add that yourself. So when you log in, Parent Portal looks like this if you don't know already. You will log in and it will look like this on your screen. You need to see 18-19 school year. Typically, we like to do a live demo for this, but we have a couple weeks, which the good news is that means you have more time to plan, but it just means we can't show you live, so that's why we've got the screenshots. Again, this will be on our website, so you can go back and refer to it, plus you've got your packet as you guys are actually making your selections. So it'll say 18-19 school year, and then you're looking for required, requested, and then alternate courses. Required means that's what your student has been recommended for. So you may get in there and your student has been recommended for 4 courses, like you can see up there, or they maybe have been recommended for 5 or 6 courses. It just depends on what your student was involved in middle school. What you then need to do, what the student responsibility is to select the requested courses. That means you are requesting to have certain electives. The last one is alternate courses. The alternate courses are because while we try very hard to give your student their requested courses, sometimes it just doesn't work in their schedule. Sometimes, especially if they're in band or drama and there's a certain class period that they have to have that class, we can't make, maybe like World Geography couldn't fit right there. So that's why we need alternate courses, alternate options that your student is good with. It may not be their first choice, but they need to be comfortable taking that. So when you are searching for a course, that is when that registration, the purple and the longest form, that's when that comes into play. You can search by course name or number, and you're going to use that registration sheet to do this. So say that you are looking for, it looks like this person is looking for intro to team sports. So you can type in intro, or you can type in the course number, you hit go, and then it'll generate this list on the side. Notice that some of the courses have an S at the end, and some have a Y. S's mean it's a semester course. A Y means it's a year-long course. On your registration sheet, the only courses that don't have an S or a Y are the ones that either are application and they have an asterisk by it, or for drama, band, and I believe chorus, we put just the generic number because, again, a lot of those sections are going to be by audition of some sort. So you can add the generic number. We will go back in over the summer and place them in the appropriate section based on what our teachers say, hey, this is the section that they made as far as auditions go. Okay? So once you find the course that you're looking for, so this one they were looking for, intro sports, entertainment and marketing, it's a year-long course, and they are trying to request it as one of their electives. So you're going to hit request, or if you've already done all of your requested courses, you're going to hit request as an alternate. We ask that every freshman request at least 3 alternates, okay? We need to have options in there to make your schedules work. The way that you know that you have successfully requested a course or requested an alternate is that it will show up back on this main screen. So again, you'll have your required courses that were recommended, then you'll have your requested courses that you're saying, ideally I want my student, or as a student, ideally I want to take these courses as my elective. And then you have your 3 alternates saying, okay, if you can't make my requested courses work, I can live with this, okay? And the way that you know that you have that you are done with the registration process is up at the top. See where it says units, and on this one it says 50 of 70. That person is not done with the registration process. It needs to say 70 of 70, and you need 3 alternates. So 70 of 70 and 3 alternates. Think of it like this. We have 7 class periods, so that's what that comes down to. That's why it needs to say 70. Otherwise, they don't have a class 1 class period, and we can't do that as much as they would love. Okay, so again, just a few registration reminders. The 70 of 70 piece is critical. Y are for year-long classes. S is for a semester class. Courses are not first come, first serve. So while the portal opens on the 21st, you do not need to be in your PJs up at 7:55 waiting to say, click, this is what we want. It's okay. You can do it anytime during the window, and I'm about to go over when the our very best to make that happen. If your student is recommended for a course, because understand that your teachers are making recommendations based on their knowledge of your student and their knowledge of the course that they'll be going into in high school, but they're also making that recommendation based on just their course. Like, they're not seeing what all of the other teachers are recommending your student for. So if you as a parent and your student are feeling overwhelmed or feeling like, I need a better balance in my schedule, you may need to do an online course waiver. So that's when you want to override a teacher's recommendation, and maybe that doesn't mean that you actually disagree with it. Maybe it's just that you think your kid needs a better balance in their schedule. But in order to, you have to do an online course waiver. That's the only way you can change this process. And that waiver does not open until Monday, March 5th at 4 p.m. There will be a link on the North Forsyth High School registration page, and that's how you will complete that. Again, remembering that the teachers are making their recommendations based on their professional judgment of your student, how they perform in class, their study habits, what they understand the requirements are going to be in high school. High school is a big transition. We are here to help them. We want them to love coming to high school. And the flip side is, if they are overwhelmed and feeling like they just can't catch their breath, then high school becomes not a positive experience. And that's not what we want. So really thinking through balance. And again, also their extracurricular stuff. You know, if your student is really involved in a high level, let's say like baseball or soccer or any of those things, football, basketball, then maybe they have extracurricular activities that are going to take up a lot of their time. Maybe they don't have a couple hours a night to do things that are academic related. So the online course waiver window is going to be Monday, March 5th at 4 p.m., and then it will close Monday, March 12th at 4 p.m. Again, that's 1 week, so you do have a weekend there to talk to your kids. Okay, so here's a breakdown of the timeline, because we've thrown a lot at you, so when do I need to do what is probably going through a lot of your heads right now. So the portal is going to open on February 21st at 8 a.m. Your students, if they are attending one of our feeder middle schools, so North Middle, Little Middle, or Liberty, they are going to receive a packet on the 21st that has the written visual directions and that legal sheet, that registration sheet for you guys. So they will bring that home again on that day. So in case you misplace this packet, it'll be there. Also, this packet will be on our website if you guys do misplace it. We are going to be having Parent Portal elective registration support on our campus. It's in the Media Center, and that is on February 26th from 4 to 6 p.m. So all the counselors will be there. If you can't get it to work, or if you're on the fence and have a question, like, let us know. That's what we're here for. So come on up, join us. We'll be happy to answer questions and help you register at that time. And then we are going to try an online registration Q&A session. This is the first time that we're adding this, and the idea here is we know you guys are really busy, and we appreciate all the time that you give to your kids, and we know you're dedicated there, but we want to try to make things a little bit easier for you. So we will be doing an online Q&A session on the 27th from 7:30 to 8 a.m., as well as from 6 to 6:30 a.m. We'll put the link on that North Forsyth High School registration page. I'll be there. Ms. Winkler, our registration admin, will be on there as well. So if you guys have questions about specifically ninth grade, I'll be able to answer those as well as Ms. Winkler. And then the portal closes on the 28th, so very quick turnaround. 1 week, there's a lot of support. But don't wait. Just go ahead and get it done. Just not at 7:55 on the 21st. Okay, and then just one last thing about the waivers. Again, just reiterating, the waivers become available on the 5th of March at 4 p.m. They're going to close on the 12th of March at 4 p.m. And then the parent portal is going to be open to view only from the 27th of March at 4 p.m. until the 29th at 4 p.m. So that's where you go back on and you make sure, yes, this is everything that we put in. This is what, including on my waivers, they've been processed. This is your way to get feedback on what all has been done. And if there's an issue at that time, then please let us know. Again, this presentation will be posted on our website, so these links are live. So I mentioned several times that different links are going to be going up on our registration page. So you can go right back to this presentation, click on the 2018-19 registration link, and I'll take you to our page. We want to get you guys in the habit of going to our counseling page. We that up to date. Ms. Marshall, one of our Raider Nation counselors, is over it. She has made it extremely user-friendly, and there is a plethora of knowledge on there, from academic support to social and emotional support to post-secondary options. So please make sure that you guys are visiting that. And then again, we want to make sure that your students are getting plugged in from the beginning. Research shows that the more connected students are to their school, the better they perform academically. So we will have an opportunity called Clubapalooza. I'll tell you guys about that in a second. At the beginning of next school year, so we want your students to get involved. But get them excited about school now. Go ahead and check out the clubs and organizations so that they're looking forward to something on our campus. And then Mr. Owens mentioned the digest, the course digest. So if you guys have questions about specific courses, or your student wants to know, what am I going to be learning in this class, that is a great resource for you to use. Okay, so now if you have your technology, go ahead and get it out. Some of you may have already done this, did this with your students, but we have set up a remind for all of our classes at North. And the idea is the counselors will be sending stuff out to you guys, reminders like for today, I sent one out last night. We'll send stuff out before registration. So if you have your phone out, then what you're going to do is text the message at lowercase f, the number 9, lowercase d, g, the number 2, and lowercase e. That's what you're texting, that's the message you're texting, I'm sorry. And you're texting it to the number 81010. I'll leave this up for a second while y'all are doing that. We will not blow up your phones, I promise. But there are going to be times, especially when Raider Rush comes around, which I'll tell you about in just a second, but where we want to be able to reach out to you, and we want to reach out to your students and help them, again, feel connected. The reality is that our generation now, our students now, they're on their phones all the time. So when we send them emails, they're like, I never saw that. But if we send them, are able to send them a remind, which comes through as a text message to them, they're quickly to respond, they see it, they seem more engaged. So that's what we're going to try this year, to help our students feel more involved. Am I good to click? I hear the deans, so y'all are doing it. All right, I'm going to go to the next slide, but if you don't get it done, it's okay. We'll, like I said, this will be on our website, or I'll go back to it when we're done with the questions and answers. Okay, so we want to let you know that this is not the last time that we are going to do some big event to support your student. We are part of the Raider U team because we love working with 9th and 10th graders. We love helping with the high school transition, and we haven't lost a student yet. So we're going to keep going and making sure your kids are good. And part of that is with Raider Rush. Please go ahead and have this on your radar. We will send something out to you as soon as we have an official date. But Raider Rush is going to be in late July. It is a fun activity. We want parents out here. We want students out here. Our Raider Commanders, which is our student leadership group, they are going to take your student around, and I promise they are going to have so much fun. We do activities where they get comfortable with the school building, but where they also get to know other students, especially upperclassmen, that are leaders in the building. Helps them get connected from the start. And then for you guys, we go ahead and we have parent sessions, and as I mentioned, we're going to go way more in detail on what you need to know, what your student needs to know to be successful their first year of high school. Then we'll have Clubapalooza, which is going to be in August. That is an opportunity for your students to go around. We set up our football field with all the clubs, athletics, or organizations that we want them to get involved in. We have over 62 options for them to get involved in. There is something for everyone. I truly believe that. And if they don't find something they like, they can start something. So, you know, please encourage students to get involved in the beginning. And then we'll also have curriculum night in August. So we want you guys to come on campus, meet their teachers at that time, ask any questions you have specific to how your students are doing in the class, and if there are any adjustments they need to make. If you guys have any questions, now's the time. Yes, ma'am. Okay, so the question is, for driver's ed, the $100 fee due by March 12th, and does that need to be, or can you pay it through My Payments Plus? I believe so.
Okay.
Ms. Sandra Sutton, though, will know for sure.
Okay. And the second thing, I just wanted to throw this out. You learned this through Raider Nation, but if your children are at all interested in going to an out-of-state college, a lot of the out-of-state universities require a fine art credit, and that's not a requirement here for graduation, so good to just know that in the back of your head. It looks like your child's going to go down that path. But they tell you all that you're in Raider Nation, but it's good to know ahead of time.
Yes. So what she's saying is, in Raider Nation, we really focus a lot on making sure your kids have the last minute things that they need for graduation. And one of those things is, if your student is looking to attend an out-of-state college, then a lot of those colleges do require a firearms credit. So if you think your student may attend anywhere outside of Georgia in particular, then you may want to go ahead and get them involved in some sort of fine arts course their freshman year. Any other questions? Great points. Anyone else? Okay, we will be up here. I'll go back and just have the remind up in case anyone didn't get a chance to finish that. We'll be up here if you have questions. And I believe Dr. Brown wants to make an announcement.
If you guys being the early birds, two questions when you go in and either talk to the content area teachers or to the faculty teachers, elective teachers. One question is,